Welcome to our fifth day of the novena.
Sixth day.
Day number six of the novena. And we are so happy that you are able to join us once again. Tonight, we pray during this novena for the Bican, the family, for L'Oreal, Ontine, especially those who are seriously ill, those who are suffering because of the coronavirus or COVID-19. We also pray for the conversion of sinners. And also, let us keep in mind during our prayers during this Holy Mass for the successful or the interview for citizenship for Mama Faye. We hope the best for her. And also, let us pray for those who are gone before us, for all our brothers and sisters who are deceased, for Ernesto Sr., for Cesar, Juanita, Hipólito Sr., Hipólito Jr., for Maria Esperanza, Giancarlo, Lucia, Naum, Juanita. We also pray for Joel Policarpio, for Matilde, Leona, Catalina, Santos, Jose, Arsenia, and Clarita. Let us gather together virtually as we have our opening hymn. Thank you for joining us in our sixth day of our novena honoring Señor Santo Niño.
Thank you.
We gather virtually together. Let us begin our celebration in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
So we take a moment together and ask God for pardon and mercy. With confidence in God's forgiveness, we cry out, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive for our sins, and one day bring us into everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who on this day revealed your only begotten Son to the world, grant in your mercy that we who know you already by faith may be brought to behold the beauty of your sublime glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Let us prepare to hear the word of God.
The first reading is taken from the book of Hebrews 1, verses 1 to 6.
The first reading is taken from the book of Hebrews, chapter 1, verses 1 to 6. Brothers and sisters, in times past, God spoke in partial and various ways to our ancestors through the prophets. In these last days, he spoke to us through the Son, whom he made heir of all things, and through whom he created the universe, who is the refulgence of his glory, the very imprint of his being, and who sustains all things by his mighty word. When he had accomplished purification from sins, he took his seat at the right hand of the Majesty on high, as far superior to the angels, as the name he has inherited is more excellent than theirs. For to which of the angels did God ever say, "You are my Son, this day I have begotten you"? Or again, "I will be a father to him, and he shall be a son to me"? And again, when he leads the firstborn into the world, he says, "Let all the angels of God worship him." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Let our response be, "Let all his angels worship him."
Let all his angels worship him.
The Lord is King. Let the earth rejoice. Let the many isles be glad. Justice and judgment are the foundation of his throne.
Let all the angels worship him.
The heavens proclaim his justice, and all peoples see his glory. Let all his angels worship him.
Let all his angels worship him.
Because you, O Lord, are the Most High over all the earth, exalted far above the gods.
Let all his angels worship him.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
My friends, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, Lord. After John had been arrested, Jesus came to Galilee proclaiming the Gospel of God. This is the time of fulfillment. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. He passed by to the Sea of Galilee. He saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting their nets into the sea. They were fishermen. Jesus said to them, "Come after me, and I will make you fishers of men. Then they left the nets and followed him. He walked along a little farther, and saw James, the son of Zebedee, and his brother John. They too were in a boat mending their nets. Then he called them. So they left their father Zebedee in their boat, along with the hired men, and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We have been so far together for 6 evenings. And our great celebration of the Sinulo is getting closer. And the anxiety is coming to our hearts and our minds. And today we hear such a beautiful gospel. Jesus is walking and calling people by name. So it's an opportunity for each of us to meditate that we too are called by name. When we were baptized, our name was given. And we were baptized in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. So today the gospel is said that Jesus is calling John and his brother and Andrew. And they are coming and following Jesus. Are you truly ready to follow Jesus when you hear that he's calling you by name? Or you are afraid to do so? That's why this evening during the novena we're praying for the conversion of sinners. Because you and me, we are ready to serve the Lord, but sometimes we are afraid to transform ourselves, to have this spiritual connection and conversion, because the fear keeps us away from following Jesus. Even though we can go faithful followers to church, and we can be attending Mass regularly, but our hearts maybe could be a little bit far away from God. So let us ask Señor Santo Niño, during this 6 day of the novena, that we too want to follow Jesus, that each time we hear our name being called by God, that we are ready to be with him, but to give us the grace that we need in order for each of us to fulfill what we promise in our baptismal day, to be priest, prophet, and king. So by doing so, we know that we are going to be more connected with God and with each other. May God be praised, now and forever. Let us offer our prayers to our living God for all the needs of our church, for His Holiness Pope Francis, for our Bishop Luis Rafael, for all the religious men and women, all who are consecrated. Especially let us pray for all the priests who are sick. The God Almighty bring them with health. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For peace, unity, and integrity among the families, especially for the family who sponsored the Mass tonight. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayers. In thanksgiving for each blessing we have received from God Almighty, and especially we humbly request that God's Holy Spirit upon Mama Faith, that she's going to have her interview in these coming days, so all to be positive. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who are seriously ill, those who are battling with COVID-19, for those who are struggling with cancer, for those who are suffering with any kind of heart disease, depression, diabetes, or any kind of illness. The God Almighty support and help them. Especially, we pray for the healing for Bikan and the family and for L'Oreal Ontin. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayers. For our family and friends and those who are going before us. Especially, we pray for Ernesto Sr., for Cesar, Juanita, Hipólito Sr., Hipólito Jr., Maria Esperanza, Giancarlo, Lucia. We also pray for Naum, Juanita, Joel Policarpio, Matilde, Leona, Catalina, Santos, Jose, Arsenia, and Clarita. The God Almighty forgive their sins and open the gates of paradise for them. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayers. Merciful God, hear our prayers and the one that we hold in our hearts through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us now continue with our offertory. pray, brothers, instituted of my sacrifice, and you may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice of him, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all of his holy church. Amen. Let us pray. With favor, Lord, we pray on this gift of your church, in which are now offered. He who by them is proclaimed, sacrifice and receive Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
My friends, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And I give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, you word to whom you make all things, who has sent us our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hand and endured his passions, but to break the bounds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with all the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, and with one voice, together we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth, so follow your glory, O Son in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed, Holy Lord, the fountain of all holiness. And holy, therefore, the gift we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he might betray the will to his own passion, he took bread and gave you thanks, broke and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. And a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we have put out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the better life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you have held worthy to be your presence and minister to you. Having we prayed our partaking the body and blood of Christ, we be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring him to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, we refer our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants, Ernesto Sr., Cesar, Juanita, Hipólito Sr., Hipólito Jr., María Esperanza, Giancarlo, Lucía, Naum, Juanita, Joel Policarpio, Matilde, Leona, Catalina, Santos, José, Arsenia, y Clarita. You have called from this world to yourself. Grant the day who were united with your Son, and a day like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also brothers and sisters, family and friends who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Although who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints have pleased you throughout the ages, we be merited to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, and for by divine teaching together, we are here to pray. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Grace and peace on our day, that by the help of your mercy we are free from sin and safe from all distress, and we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the glory is yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostle, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and grant you her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold He who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I know what is in the end of my life, but only say a word in my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring us into everlasting life. Amen. Please come forward. Body of Christ. 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 Let us pray. Go before us with heavenly light, O Lord, always and everywhere, that we may perceive with clear sight and revere with true affection the mystery in which you have willed us to participate through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you
and with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, keep us safe and protected, and the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Don't forget that this Saturday, January 16th at 10 a.m. at St. Mary Magdalene, we are having our great Sinulo honoring Señor Santo Niño, and everybody is welcome. Our Holy Mass is ended. Let us go in peace. Thanks be to God. Let us please join me now. Come closer.